Hip hop hope.
Hip hop beat. The beat is your mind. If hip beat. And we all rhymes. The beat is your mind. And we all rhymes. The beat is your mind. If and we all rhymes. Got your ass moving like you sticking a wax. Hip hop beat. Got your ass moving like you sticking a wax. Everything I hate is rap. Everything I hate is rap. The beat is your mind. The beat is your mind. And we all rhymes. Got your ass moving like you sticking a wax. Got your ass moving. Everything I hate is rap. Everything I hate is rap. Everything I hate is rap. Everything I hear is rap.
Taking it to the next dimension, trying to relax among so much tension, living too fast to take measures of prevention, futures in question. This art is our protection, the only weapon against oppression. PJs divided in sections, divide and conquer was their intention. Hip hop unites us, so pay attention. I hope you know hip hop hope. I hope you care. I hope you dare to make a difference here. I hope you share. I hope I can help you bear the loss of someone dear. I hope you understand the struggle is worth more than double. I hope you see the light. I hope you scream and fight to change what's wrong to right. I hope you dream at night. I hope you reach new heights. Hope your hope is not hidden down below. Your heart feeling choked. Your hometown is up in smoke. Before it actually happened, it was like a joke. Family never came home and they hoped life would be found below the twisted iron. Misty faces crying. Hoped it wasn't true that so many had died. Trying to hang on to stolen moments out of windows broken. This is the place it all happens. The lights, the fights, ghetto's children rapping. This is not your 40-acre lawn. This is not your animal stock farm. This is NYC.
I don't even know what hope is, to tell you the truth. I think it's something that we all just grew up with. It's something that the fucking white man told us it was all right. You know what I mean? Just a word that he threw out there. Hope can mean kill in another country. You know what I'm saying? Is hope really hope?
Hope, H-O-P, hope. Well, hope would be you're looking for a better tomorrow, a better today, a better something. A better of anything would be hope.
Hip-hop has hope to change the world.
Hope is like all we have in the ghetto.
The world turns on a hip-hop beat, that's why it slams. Morning's a metaphor, daytime's a simile. Nighttime's a curse word, making it all chemistry. See the time is tempo, and we all rhyme. Different people, different samples, the beat is your mind.
I was not too far from here. I was two blocks on the building right across the street. In fact, I work over there. So when I look up, I see the first tower on fire. So, you know, I have friends and cousins that I lost in the building. You know, I went crazy.
Hip-hop needs to change. This, I hope this is the revolution of hip-hop. Consciousness, respect, thought. You know, it's so easy to point the finger and to hate and to fight and talk about money and talk about pimping and talk about hoes. It's like, yo, come on, look, what's next?
Jumping from 80 floors, we can't take any more. It's on, an eye for an eye. Don't realize that's why we lost so many lives. Husbands and wives, black, brown, and white. It just isn't right, but that's how we fight. Dirty, that's how we rule worldly. Don't think of the innocent people we might be hurting. The lies get buried, the truth gets blurry. Too late to worry, ignorance comes from fury. Get on your knees and start with your Hail Marys. This world is scary, the end might be coming in a hurry. We don't care.
I went to 14th Street and 1st Avenue. 3 hours after that happened, and I did a painting. It was that I felt like, since I lost my friends, and a cousin of mine's there, and I thought my sister-in-law was gone, but thanks God she made it out safe. You know, I did a painting, a tribute to them. And not just to them, but to everybody in general that lost relatives and families there.
10 years ago, I was a teenager. Working, I used to go to Murray Bertram High School over by Brooklyn Bridge, and I would walk this whole area to go on the 108th floor to Shearson Lehman Brothers.
I used to work in the World Financial Center right next door to it. I walked through the World Trade Center every day. I used to be a messenger. You know what I'm saying? I have an ID from the World Trade Center in my house right now. I was in there mostly every day for a minute. You know what I'm saying? So I knew mad people there, you know? it's gone, but God bless. I wasn't there. I guess it wasn't my time.
You never know when it's your time to go, so you better live each day like it's your last. And you better make peace with all those people because hatred carries too much weight.
Hip-hop unites us, so pay attention. I hope you know hip-hop hope. I hope you care. I hope you dare to make a difference here.
You go to Japan, you got hip-hop. You go to Switzerland, you got hip-hop. It's worldwide. It's official. Now people that used to be like, oh, hip-hop, that's that black shit. Or hip-hop, that's that ghetto shit. Now everybody wants to be ghetto. You go to, like, the suburbs, you got kids that want to be ghetto. I go to Puerto Rico, it's blazing hot. They got hoodies on because they want to be like hip-hop.
Simply, it's music of the streets. I think it was born in the streets, probably more than other music. And I'll confess I'm a rock and roller.
Oh, well, actually, you know what? I'm a opera fan, so I really have no idea what hip-hop is.
The big part of hip-hop is making something out of nothing. And you see that with the DJ taking a turntable, which is something that you listen to music with, and using it as an instrument. Taking your mouth, turning it into an instrument. Taking something that you would paint a garage with, like an aerosol can, and turning that into your paintbrush. So hip hop is really about taking what's around your environment and transforming it.
Hope is to wish, as far as I'm concerned, that things will get better in the long run. And I think we all have some kind of openness, especially after September 11th.
Yeah, hip hop has the power to heal. Healing words have done a lot, man. I've had hip hop songs that made me cry.
I like gospel music. I like hymns. And since I found the Lord, since I found Jesus, I'm just more and more drawn to that type of music. The other seems so empty to me.
Get out the hood. We love the hood. I'm the hood.
Music brings out emotion and thought and feeling in your body, and that emotion is expressed through dance.
The blood, the heart, the sweat, all of it is really important to hip-hop as a culture. A nation that can't dance isn't really proud of itself, isn't really confident.
You know, a building blew up, a lot of people died. I feel for them because I know some of them, but it can't, it's like all this terror, I don't feel that. I never felt safe living in New York City. You know, you living in a war zone every day. So, you know, I'll be walking down the street at 3 o'clock in the afternoon and hear a gunshot. Bow! You know, you don't do nothing. You just keep walking, all right? So nothing really changed. I mean, it's just like, it's like a new threat now. You know, all right, now I can get shot, I can get stabbed, or I can get blown up in a building.
African Americans were the ones who developed hip hop, who were the genesis of hip hop, who brought it out. And it was out of their own cultural tradition. And we as either Latinos, you know, people from the Caribbean or from wherever, have expounded upon it. We've all taken to it.
This same little port, this same little New York Harbor is where all the immigrants used to come from other nations to come in here. And let me tell you how America works, kid. Let me tell you how America works, man. This is hip-hop hope for you right here. This is hip-hop knowledge. Every class of immigrants that ever came to this country became the low class of immigrants. Whether it was Chinese folks, whether it was Irish people, whether it was Germans, whether it was Polish, everybody who came here was the underclass, mind you know what I mean? Everybody who came here from another country was your maids and your janitors or whatever, and they learned how to move up in this world to reach a certain status quo so that their people is moving at a certain rate in the level. African American people were brought here way before the Irish came, way before the Italians came, way before the Jews came, and we don't have shit. We still are underclass. We still in the ghettos. Because everybody who came from somewhere else started in the ghettos and moved up. Everybody had to come here broke and poor and work their way into having something. We've been here before everybody. We built this country on our blood, sweat, and tears, on our backs, with our grandparents, with this cotton industry. You know what I mean? We built the finance of this country. We created the riches in America, and we still live in the ghettos, cousin. Wake up. Stop telling me about the club. Stop telling me about Cristal. Stop telling me about the strippers at the spot. For real, get on your job, black people. Stop playing around. All you fake ass rap y'all niggas is politicians, really, because y'all selling me bullshit. Y'all selling me dreams. Telling me I could be like you, and you not even being like yourself, man.
So basically, 911 has just told me now, whatever I'm gonna do, I gotta attack it right now.
Please, could you hold on? Could you turn your TVs on and see why babies is crying? Why motherfuckers is still down there by the World Trade breathing that shit dying? We got anthrax, you know what I'm saying? Motherfuckers taking shit to the max. People with bad backs, they out there like, yo, why my family gotta hurt? Why they gotta be put in the dirt? Why they gotta be taking DNAs? Why they gotta let motherfuckers know why they shooting with strays? Why I got to be like that in the hood? Why it ain't all good? Why you doing the things that you should? Why the president trying to blind us from secret society? Why people going out doing things in different varieties? Why I got to be like that?
For the most part, it's just some of the language that's used. I do associate with violence.
No, I ain't afraid of no terrorism. I mean, they gave me a gun. I killed these motherfuckers.
Violence is everywhere, man. So it's going to come out in hip-hop because there's people that are enraged. There's people that are exasperated. They're already upset with their living conditions. They're upset about a lot of things. And it's not just in the music. It's just I got my brothers around me that they're tired of going through their struggle in life. And they had it up to here, and they lost it. And they're ready to lose it. So that gets me all anxious and crazy too, and I'm going through the same thing myself. I'm gonna go inside the vocal booth and I'm gonna speak on it, and it's not gonna be a nice thing. And when we talk about what's going on with us. I'm going down the street, a dude is looking at me hard. All right, this dude, you know, boom, boom. And you're venting when it's like talking to your man. When you're spitting rhyme, when I'm kicking my rhymes, it's like I'm talking to my man right there. I'm talking to my people. It's like, yo, this is what's happening. Yo, you won't believe what happened the other day. Boom, boom, that's all it is.
In the graffiti world, you gotta be very careful if you cross out the wrong name, because there's violence right behind it. A lot of violence. People die, get killed over somebody crossing them out. And every graffiti artist know that. You gotta go by the rules.
17th birthday, in a group home at the time back then, Staten Island. Came up to the Bronx, come hang out with the family, come get a haircut from my cousin Astro. You know, that was the routine, go get a fresh cut. Boom. And I hear a car pulling up behind me, like in the street, but I hear the brakes, like, squeaking. You know how you hear the brakes squeaking on an old car. I turn around just suspiciously, but I'm in a good mood, so everything, smile on my face, all that. I see the driver first. I see the passenger. And I look into the rear. I look in the rear behind the driver. I see the person in the rear with the gun out the window, pointed at me already. One bullet, dead to the spine.
Why are you aiming your guns at me? Cause I'm too young for the dirt that bleeds, son. I'm just trying to get back to the street before it happened to you like it happened to me.
Shot in my back right now. I'm on the floor. I was like young and healthy basketball fanatic, so I was like about 215, 225, just muscle. So I'm trying to get up, and I realize I can't get up. I call for help. People start shutting their windows like they don't want to get involved. Luckily, you know, some people noticed me down there, came, seen, noticed the blood, called the police. My cousin came out the building. Ambulance taking forever. I'm laying on the floor, shot up. That shit was crazy. I used to have nightmares about that shit when I was in the hospital. About getting shot like over and over and over. Same place, same time, just different situations, you know what I mean? So I spent about a year in the hospital. 17-year-old in the hospital with nothing but people with, you know, with hip replacements, knee replacements, strokes. So I'm in there with all old people going to therapy every day for a year on some mistaken identity shit. So trust me when I tell you I understand circumstance. That's a lot of where my attitude comes from too. Word up, I went through trials that made me a man. So I'm thankful to God, man. For what he put me through, because it made me strong. Feel me.
Yo, why you aiming that shit at me? I was happy, I'm a knuckle game nigga. Why you looking at me? I had bullets flying past me, but never at me. And then y'all fucking gon' blast me. At worst in the back me. Superstar athlete, detached from his feet. I was nasty on the rim, broke catastrophe to the gym. On second thought, y'all sped off like, was it actually him? Did we shoot the right dude? Should we go back and try again?
I believe they're wasting the money and the time. We're not there. We're fighting an invisible man, so. You know what I'm saying? You kill him, somebody else is gonna come.
Yeah, we're all equal. We're all the same. Let's find peace. Let's not make war. This is not a time for war. Let's find peace. Souls can't rest in peace unless we give them that peace.
In hip-hop, there's a transformative element. We've talked about it with the instruments and the turntables, but there's also a transformative element in terms of violence to peace.
How could you be against abortion, but you're pro-war?
you know, that's death to me. I mean, that's evil to me.
Dyverse fell to the earth from hell. It kept him grounded, but Pepper failed, and he still kept it real. Plus, he kept it to the vets and the best in his field. Finessing his spell, he's skillful. He could just rebuild you. An experimental earful if the tape played through. There's no telling where taste might take you and break a loose prosthetic. It's the prophetic intellect and rhetoric rhyme that hits you harder with the message that I represent like 174th. Just kept letting me off, licking at the niggas in the crosswalk laws, because this is a vision. This a religion and it's a living in a dark that can leave your heart swimming in your parka with garshes and godfathers. I smoked out the horrors and it's hell, man. It's harvest, ill starters with the partnership. Recording me would be 140's hardest mix, because I suffer from regardlessness of artists made of bricks.
You're born into this life, you're given things as far as resources and influences and inspirations, and then in turn you react to those, do what's in your power to do, and then create something for the people that come after you. That's really how life works, really. It's a continuum.
We're in a war zone, broken bones, broken home, fighting over oil, but killing the ozone. Germ warfare infects the air.
We're here fighting over oil, and we're fighting over this. In a couple of years, the way we're going, we're gonna be fighting over clean water. We're gonna be fighting over that last drop. People don't even see that. We're so busy building incinerator companies to make money. All we're doing is creating pollution. But we don't care, because we're thinking about the almighty dollar that's fitting in our pockets. If it were me, I would go back to nature, boy. That would be it. No more gasoline-run cars, nothing like that. Everybody would get their 40 acres. You would have to plant your little farm. You would have to keep a well. I mean, I'm ready.
I was asleep. My roommate wakes me up and goes, yo, the World Trade Center is on fire. I didn't even believe the shit. I turn the TV on, I'm watching the first building burn the first tower. Then I see the second plane hit the next tower, and I say to myself, it's a reality now. It's no longer a conspiracy theory. It's no longer hypothetical that certain things about to take place. You know what I mean? Because we like to, us in this country, we like to ignore shit. We like to act like everything is great. We gotta get another shot of the actual skyline without the towers, man.
Beat, life, movement, ancestors, vibrations, friends, dance, the beat.
Who that?
It's La Bruja, bringing some dancing to ya.
Dance is an important element in society as a whole, because dance helps you understand music. Music is a universal language, and dance is the interpreter.
Shake a hand, everyone dance. Come on, you can't dance, you don't stand a chance.
When you hear music, specifically hip-hop music, it's how you move to it, how you feel it, and that's where dance comes in.
I guess it does have a rhythm, but not one that I appreciate. I just get a very, the word that's coming to my mind is a negative feeling when I hear it.
Hip-hop junkie, Shakespeare in my soul, and that right Uncle Will, because to be or not to be, is the question, and I choose to be. I choose to be me. Let the world know what you see is what you get. 100% unadulterated me. Because I refuse to conform to the world and its norm. I refuse to conform to the marriage norm, the 2.3 children norm, the white picket fence norm, the nice cute sex norm. I like to fuck hard.
Hip hop is really good because they really be rapping about the feelings, you know, what they feel and what they see and stuff like that. It's just like everyday life stuff.
The role of women in hip-hop reflects the role of women in life in general. Basically, as sex objects. You see a woman in an advertisement, you know, in order to sell that product, you know, you're not selling her mind. You know, oh, she's so intelligent. Buy this shower gel. No, you know, she has on, you know, a little lingerie. She looks attractive according to the standards that attractiveness is set by, you know, and through that, she's gonna sell this. Damn. So basically, she's being pimped, you know what I'm saying? America uses women as whores.
It's a man's world. James Brown wasn't playing, James knows it. It's a man's world. It's a muscle penis thing. But you know, I mean, if women stopped looking at their tits and ass as a ticket to get in and they saw it more of a beautiful, powerful gift of heaven. I mean, breasts are for giving milk and vagina is for giving birth. You know, it's not for giving it up to everybody or whatever. You know what I mean?
First of all, women run everything. They just don't know it. Most women just don't know it. It'll give us a life, man. And besides, pussy can conquer every nation. You see what a blowjob almost did to our country, right? You know what I mean? Women control everything. They just got to understand it, man. They got to see it in themselves. Stop taking your clothes off in your video. I love beautiful naked women, too. But I think there's certain things that's for behind closed doors. You know what I mean? Or if you want to take your clothes off and you want to shake your fatty or whatever you want to do as far as, you know, being a part of this industry or entertainment, like take your little Kims or your Foxys, they want to show all their cleavage or whatever because sex sells, that's great. But what's left after the sex? What's left after that? Where's the substance under that? Because nobody want to make a whole housewife, and we all know that.
Well, you know what they say, live like a whore, die by the sword. Well, you know what they say, live in the ghetto, die in the ghetto.
I was with my children, thank God. I was with my children in my grandmother's house, and we were eating breakfast together. And then we turned on the news, and there it was. I couldn't believe it. I still can't believe it. So many innocent people, you know?
Traveling is sort of a big deal now, you know? Traveling, I haven't been out of the country since. I haven't really been out of the city since. And it's just made me appreciate New York as a whole much more than ever before. And, you know, my family, my children, my friends, my job, the music, the culture, you know, it makes you really appreciate what you have and really take, put it into perspective of how it could all end tomorrow.
Don't decline, everyone. Come together, move as one. We can have some fun. Rotate your bonds. If you're chilling in a mansion or you dancing in the slums, raise your hands, my friends. To the sun, to the moon, to the sun. Come on.
Dancing is supposed to be something that's like, you know, aesthetically beautiful and the lines are supposed to be a certain way. And yet it's just all broken in hip hop. So I believe that that's just the way we're gonna be in the future. You know, just breaking down the lines that the status quo.
I'm turntableist. I'm into the different styles of scratching and doing body tricks. And beat juggling, breaking down beats with music, with the sound that has already been recorded on vinyl. And there's not that many DJs that can do that.
A lot of healing that needs to be done. There's a lot of movement that needs to be made. You know what I'm saying? So hip hop can be used in all those manners, you know, in all those facets to make things happen right now, to heal, to motivate, inspire, and to rebuild.
How do we fight back? Well, we fight back through hip hop. We fight back through our skills. We fight back by being healthy, eating right, having dreams, and making it happen.
Which is, you know, the art of making beats with your mouth.
Hope is not in my vocabulary for the simple fact that I feel, as far as hope, I think if you need something, you want something, you go make it happen. You shouldn't sit down in your house and hope or I dream of it or I'm crossing my fingers, you know. It should just be hip-hop, basically. If you want it, you go after it. I never hope. I never dream. I don't even know what a dream is. A few nightmares, yeah.
Dreams we chase is a hope we have inside to do what we love, but in money we must confide. The Benjamins, yo, that's really what it's all about. Because without it, life's fucked up, and you know what? It causes doubt. Makes you second-guess when you're low on dough. Shit gets delayed. Your progress seems too fucking slow. Is the number one reason for hopelessness.
Makes me feel hopeless. The hunger, growing up poor. Some nights not even eating. You know what I'm saying? With my father out there, mother on welfare, my father out there, he on compensation because he got hurt on his job. At the same time, he gotta have it. We broke and he gotta have it. You know what I'm saying? My mother broke and she gotta have it. She on crack, he on dope. But we broke. They got to have it because they got a habit. You know what I'm saying? How you broke with a habit? How we go to sleep hungry, waking up 3 in the morning eating spicy ham sandwiches. 3 a.m. is not dinner time, but that's when we ate a lot of nights. You know what I'm saying? opening the refrigerator, nothing there but water or ice. Going to free lunch. Sometimes that was the best thing that ever happened to the hood. Free lunch. Government fools, we could go there, eat breakfast, go there, eat lunch. Sneak some food out for later. I hope we eat later that night. That's what makes me hopeless. Cause it's like, I grew up too poor for the bullshit to be wishing on a star. I got to make it happen. Can't wait for the star to fall out the sky. I gotta get in that spaceship and go grab it. You know what I'm saying? I got to reach for that. That's what makes me hopeless.
I don't dream no more. I don't dream no more. My eyes is wide open. I don't have room to dream anymore, man. I have aspirations, I have goals, you know what I mean? But as far as dreams, man, I'm not walking around sleep living in a dream no more.
So now you wanna talk about hope? So now you wanna talk about dreams?
Hey, hi, hey, hi, hey.
So now you wanna hear what I wrote? So now you wanna know what it means?
Hey, hi, hey, hi.
It was like a wake-up call. You know, like, we all know that saying here today and going tomorrow, you know, in a split second, in the blink of an eye, but that was totally unexpected, so it was like, damn, I might not be here tomorrow.
Osama bin Laden is threatening more terrorism.
949, till there's no one left to stare. We're blind anyway, so we don't care. Premonitions made real, what was considered fiction. Death was put into play by the devil's contingent. The government in charge knew the terrorists were at large, but did not deter them from their mission. You think they don't study predictions? They want the third war, and this gave them permission to continue execution, innocent persecution. The world of misconfusion, don't know that we are all losing. The earth that we've been using, abusing, sucking the juices. How will we heal from the bruises? What are the uses? The fuse is lit, I predict we'll lose quick. What Mother Nature built before she got sick? What will you eat? What will you drink? When money can't get you shit, the snake offered you the apple, but you can't chew what you bit. And that's it, damn it went by so quick.
Osama bin Laden is threatening more terrorism.
949, so there's no one left to stare. We're blind anyway, so we don't care. And 949, so there's no one left to stare. We're blind anyway, so we don't care.
The safest place to me on 9/11 was the hood. You know what I mean? I didn't need to be in Battery Park City, living in Battery Park City, you know, where all the rich rappers and all the politicians and motherfuckers with all the money was at. I was happy to be in the hood that day on 9/11, because I knew it wasn't no planes crashing into the building that I live in.
Because of the hood, that's why my focus been good. Because of the hood, a bitch gotta do what she should. Because of the hood, Dutchess wasn't brought up too good. Because of the hood, Negroes been shot when they stood. Because of the hood, cracked open weed sales real good. Cause of the hood, my persona stay rough like sugar. Cause of the hood, bunk beds broke down from cheap wood. Cause of the hood, moms and pops broke fiends in the hood. Cause of the hood, cops are wearing slaps and beat them real good. Scared of the hood, we love the hood, I'm the hood.
You need money to live. It's that important, you know? You need money for everything. I needed money to get here to meet you, or I wouldn't have been able to come here. You know what I'm saying? We definitely need money. Money make the world go around, but at the same time, it's the root of all evil.
I really want to be rich, but it seems the rich is foul. See, most claiming it's business, that's the way in. You got to be a prostitute to be a made man. See, thugs will always keep thugging and players play in. Either you're real and you're broke, or rich but gate in.
Money's money, baby.
I'm not gonna do anything that's gonna keep me poor. I definitely am on it to get money, because the things that I wanna do for my community are gonna cost money. And I wanna find a way that's gonna be lucrative and that's gonna generate money for the things that I wanna do.
Hip hop came from a poor black man. All right, and this is what we gonna do. We're gonna bang on the lunch table on our lunch break. We're gonna make a beat. We gonna say something that rhyme. You know what I'm saying? We created this. Black man created this. But behind it all, the white man is on top of it. You know what I'm saying? He writing out most of the checks.
The most commercial aspect of hip hop is the albums that are sold. There's a history in this country of black artists being ripped off by corporations that distribute and market music.
This generation, plagued with the years and tears of past and present oppression on behalf of the progression of monetary aggression, that subliminal intervention blocking us from the direct connection that breathes life into our soul.
Take a cat like Busta Rhymes. Busta Rhymes say he lived down the block from the WTC. Ask him how much his little household things that he paid for and them big screen TVs meant to him when that damn building was falling down and people thought the earth was coming to an end. Understand? Half of the shit that people rap about is about nothing.
A lot of people are blinded with the chase for money, not to get money, because everybody wants money, but it's the chase that confuses a lot of artists. That's when a lot of artists start to sell their soul for this game. And then once you sell your soul once, there's no way that you can turn back.
There is no reason why, with all the food that is produced and thrown away in this country, that people gotta starve. For them to tell you that they trying to go help another country and people over here ain't eating, cops is putting plungers in people's asses, shooting people 41 times, and you want to tell me about what's going on in another country and you can't get your own country right?
We in the belly of the beast. But don't just chill in the belly of the beast. You got to get up out there or the beast going to come get you. You got to move around. You know what I'm saying? Put yourself out there. Do different things. It's all right.
Yo, I lived in the pit of hell. I never had to fall. Ate out of trash dumps. Other bums with the front, they caught lumps. Porter thought he was my home. X-ray vision for cigarette butts. I head uptown, illegally bound. See my niggas luckily with that dark brown. Bumming Sunny 5 for a Dutch. Even homeless, I was still plush. Ate off ends of hot dogs, tasting like must. McDonald's fries, cold stole the nations for ketchup. Went to time 23 degrees, my chops were smashed up. Fucking dope fiends, a 41st he left in the box with the neck up. Clinic appointments was necessary to buy with the checkup. I started freebasing for a pepper.
Damn. You make me love you. Embarrassed rappers every time I thug you. Changing your words, patterns, past the margins when I smudge you. Sometimes I speak your thoughts, it's like writing your style is free. It's like my mind becomes a freak when I'm talking about you and me. Took you shopping on Pro Tools for kick loops and snares. I admit, I cheated on you with bass lines and pairs.
I don't know what I'ma do, man. I think I'ma go insane, really, man. Cause I done lived this so long and I'm trying to get my word out to the world. And it's so hard when you don't got that demo. And you just a raw artist.
If I could change the world, I would change it with my art.
Getting our people to think consciously, getting our young people to respect themselves and respect their elders, it's now a level of positivity. You know, we have to start thinking of the negatives, the things that our people have been suffering. I mean, I'd rather somebody or a young person or whatever person, instead of picking up that needle to shoot up, they're gonna pick up a microphone and sing, or pick up a spray can and do a mural, or whatever, you know?
I wanna make a difference in New York, you know, not just for the people that live in New York City, but the outsiders. When they come to the city, I want them to see color live. I mean, I'm tired of these buildings, black and white, gray, you know what I'm saying? They look disgusting. Why put a little color in people's lives?
Hip-hop has already changed the world. You know, you can see the kids of America. You know, you see the little white kids in their neighborhoods. They're wearing baggy jeans and they have flat tops and dreads and they're wearing platinum chains. Hip-hop, it changed the world ever since it started. You know, once we gave you that kick right there, that was it. And that was it. That's all she wrote.
It would be more about what we do than what we have.
The streets are telling you the truth. The streets are telling you the truth, but ain't nobody listening. Ain't nobody listening. And the worst part about it is we got too many brothers who came from the street and made it to do something, and they not listening no more. That's why I shit on people when I throw my rhymes. You know what I mean? I'll disrespect anybody in the rhyme and call out their name, and it ain't trying to get fame off your name. It's to call you out, man. If you're making a lot of money, man, do something with that fucking money, man. Go spend that money in the community center in your hood. Go put some computers in the goddamn hood. Go teach some kids economics so niggas don't gotta grow up and work for somebody else who gonna slave them for $11 an hour knowing they making $25 an hour off your ass.
Word of mouth is the conspiracy behind the design. I heard about chemical warfare and welfare and horsehair cut off from my traditions of a slaughter. I walk with blood.
Words? Well, wow. I mean, you know, people get killed over words.
A painting on the wall is 1,000 words.
Check it, yo. I put words together like Scrabble while herbs get together and babble, slaying like herds of cattle. When it's time to battle, turn an open mic bar into an abattoir. Keep a loaded pen, toted and wet the page. The sage raised my thoughts to the gauge, ready to blaze the opposition. Throw my victims in a torture rack till a spinal cord snaps. Torture raps or quit. Nigga, you slip. Try to flip. I'll take it back to bases. Whip you like a dominatrix.
Words are like spells. You know, when you say something, you manifest it.
I did you a cappella. I fed you so much metaphors, you just kept getting better. Your cousin Mike feedbacks to blow you off. He's mad. I scream your love aggressively to show who's boss. I'm trying to match you with some.
In my music, I really do try to have a commitment to positivity.
Like a lot of people say, that like as soon as people stutter, things that come out their heart is pure. And that's all I live, is pure hip hop.
We make it sincere, and I'm gonna make it real, and I'm gonna make it deal with things, you know, police brutality, war. Like, you know, I'm not gonna just make something that doesn't deal with that stuff. You know, struggles in neighborhoods, violence, like all that stuff was there, but the intention was really to elevate and to uplift.
I mean, I think, you know, some unity amongst people, like people really respecting each other, getting more aware of the fact that we are the same, that we are human beings. Even if we call God Allah, and even if we call God Jehovah, or call God Buddha, or if we call God whatever, Olodumare, or Atabe, or whatever, whoever we believe in, even if we call God the goddess Mother Nature, it's like, let us respect each foundation. Let us really, really respect each other for our differences. You know, when is that gonna happen?
When I get in and make my mark, it'll be a new purpose. When my team get in and show them how it's supposed to be done, it'll be a new purpose. You understand what I'm saying? When we make it a reason for you to even want to go to the store and pick up an album to hear our shit, because it's fruitful, it's real. You know what I'm saying? I'm like the most blossomous flower in the garden of hip-hop right now.
When hip-hop really started back in the early 70s or whatever, those was gang members who was coming together to have a good time. So instead of fighting, they took their battle out in dances, they took their battle out in DJing, they took their battles out in rhymes. It brought people who were enemies together. We lost sight of that. Now we see hip-hop as a vehicle to make money, a vehicle as a way to get out of the ghetto and make money.
This could be it. Everybody's listening now. What are we gonna say?
And everybody wants to glorify themselves. You can't glorify yourself. To put yourself before God is idolatry, son. Remember that. You know what I mean? And all idols must fall.
What are we gonna use our voice? Are we gonna use it responsibly? Because a lot of our hip-hop heads, a lot of the artists, they're not using their voice responsibly. They're just doing the regular thing, the bling-bling thing, the thing that's gonna bring the money. It's so safe. Like, no one has the balls to take a stand and say something.
This is love. This is hate. Union. Separate. This is war. This is peace. This is vegetarians. This is pork reef. This is mom. This is pop. This is cons. This is cops. This is poor. This is prop. This is blind. This is watch. This is why. This is not. This is cool. This is hot. This is shots for the bombs to stop. This is a slap in your face. This is a tender embrace. This is purified rivers. This is nuclear waste. This is not too soon. This is not too late. This is the beginning and the end. This is fate.
The world is crazy right now. The world is crazy. It's in revelations. It's like the end of the world is here.
No one's taking any chances. So that the overall decline in hip hop is in the creativity, not in the culture as a whole. The culture is worldwide now. We're about to extend past this planet.
We got a bodega and a liquor store on every corner in the hood. You think that's a coincidence? It's like they want us down. They want us appeased. They want us asleep. They don't want us thinking. And I think that hip-hop could be the tool that wakes us all up.
That hunger with hip-hop. Hip-hop with real MCs, you know what I'm saying, with real artists that have that hunger. That's why your first album, they say, is always your best, because you was so hungry. But after you eat, a lot of them get comfortable and they lose it. I need to spit to that beat or that melody or whatever it is. You can't get that comfortability. You have to keep that hunger. You know what I'm saying? You got to remember where you came from or you'll never know where you're going.
I couldn't get to the city for a couple of days because the ferry wasn't running. And it was really, that was the thing that really hit me the most, is being isolated, being disconnected from my family and my friends. But when I finally got to New York, like, what really, really grounded me and got me together was Union Square. And Union Square was just really inspiring. There was just every day, you know, there was a memorial and candles and flowers and people doing their poetry and people playing music and drumming and just, you know, the artistic community of downtown really came out. and, you know, was keeping that hope alive.
I feel safe going anywhere because I feel divinely protected, and I'm ready to go. When it's my time to go, it's my time to go. And I know that I've done everything that I could with every day that I had to make a difference and to plant a seed and to change and make people aware of what's going on and aware of our culture, the beautiful things of life and the bad things of life too. Things that need to be changed and things that need to remain the same. Things that should be preserved.
What happened to a song just being a song?
You know, we're very creative. We see beyond, a little bit ahead. And that's what makes us paint.
If you want to accomplish anything in life, you have to first see it inside your mind. So to me, you have no choice but to be a visionary if you want to manifest your dreams.
Hope is like wishing, you know what I mean? It's wishing for something better, waiting for something better. You know what I mean? There's nothing wrong with having hope, but don't sit on your hope. You understand what I'm saying? Don't sit around and wait for something to happen. Don't sit around and look for some miracle to take place for your hopes to become a reality. If you hope for something better, you're supposed to work for something better. You know what I mean? Word up. That's where faith comes in. You gotta have faith in the fact that you can actually do that. Faith and hope is like brother and sister.
Is this the movement's goal? And how do I know if all these efforts are not in vain? The remain, the pain is stained. Our generation's aim to gain its purpose in our existence. Resistance against all this societal persistence. Persistence, persistence.
This generation sparks the revolution.
I looked at the towers falling as almost like a blessing. You know what I mean? And not in the sense that, yo, I feel for everybody who lost their lives, man. One of my lady friends lost her brother, man. Rest in peace, Gunza. You know what I mean? My aunts were down there. They had to escape. You know, people falling out the building. The shit was horrible. It was a travesty. But did it take that for y'all to realize and wake up and open your eyes and say, damn, man, this shit goes on around the world every day. We think we are immune to it. We think that, you know what I mean, we impregnable over here in the United States. And they let us know that anybody's life can be taken. Anything can happen.
Hey, we New Yorkers, baby. We got to take care of it. You know, we for real. You know what I'm saying? We ain't going to let something like this take us down. You know what I'm saying? Whatever happens, happens, you know, but we're going to be standing firm.
Hope is that light at the end of the tunnel. To know that the struggles you go through now are only for the purpose of the greater good, or something that's going to alleviate the struggles of the life that we exist today.
Hip-hop hope. I think it's like hip-hop hope. Like, you hope hip-hop be a better thing or a better place or turn back into the culture that it was originally from.
I don't feel a threat. I don't feel a threat. I mean, this government is just as much a threat to me as any terrorist. I mean, that may sound fucked up, but I can't forget a lot of things. You know, I come from Diallo Town. That's my hood. You know, I saw that go down. I mean, I don't know. I might be thought anti-American to say what I really feel, especially about a president I didn't vote for, especially about a president that didn't win fairly. It wasn't a democracy when that went down, you know? That's like more thug than any street I've seen in the Bronx.
For a crackhead to try to get off a drug, that's hope. For me trying to be a star, to go sell millions of records and go back to my hood and say what's up to niggas who don't have, that's hope. To even give a smile is hope.
That's what we're going through right now, the Great Depression. It's depression what we going through greatly. It's real right now. You know, we just out here trying to live, but who's to say what we breathing in right now?
To me, hip-hop hope is, let's turn this music into a vehicle for change.
Hope is a rope when you feel that you can't cope, but not a rope to hang, but a rope to climb. Hope is a chime, hope is design, hope is a rhyme. Hope is sunshine.
That's God's glory right there. You know what I mean? You can't put a price on that right there. You can't purchase that, man, but that's there for you every day for free, and we don't even take advantage of it. You know what I mean? The sun give us life, man. Without the sun, we wouldn't have nothing, and we take shit like that for granted. We take air for granted. We take water for granted. We take everything for granted, and there's gonna come a time when money can't buy you shit.
Who are you to tell me what I could say? Isn't it about being real?
Hope is this. All y'all artists is rocking $600,000 bracelets and big chains.
While you go back to your hood and niggas ain't got fresh Tims on their feet, niggas ain't got socks on, niggas ain't got fucking t-shirts, that's hope. Come back to your hood, sir, and give hope.
The job that I accepted before the one I took, it was actually in World Trade, it was in building number 2 on the 33rd floor for Amex. And I turned it down for another job because it was closer to school. And the job hours from 7 to 3, and I just keep reliving it over and over again. It was only 7 months ago. Had I taken that job, I would have been in the building when that plane hit, so.
I hope you know hip-hop hope. I hope you care. I hope you dare to make a difference here. I hope you share. I hope I can help you bear the loss of someone dear. I hope you understand the struggle is worth more than double. I hope you see the light. I hope you scream and fight to change what's wrong to right. I hope you dream at night. I hope you reach new heights. Hope your hope is not hidden down below. Your heart feeling choked. Your hometown is up in smoke. Before it actually happened, it was like a joke. Family never came home and they hoped life would be found below the twisted iron. Misty faces crying. Hoped it wasn't true that so many had died. Trying to hang on to stolen moments out of windows broken. This is the place it all happens. The lights, the fights, ghetto's children rapping. This is not your 40-acre lawn. This is not your animal stock farm. This is NYC where everything comes true. Fantasies to broken dreams, cries of joy and horror screams. This is crazy how many people don't say a thing to Joe Schmo or G.I. Homo. Mama buns are the people that sell trinkets for a dollar on the train. Just one. This is not Kansas anymore. This is a new Oz filled with oohs and ahs. This is a place between Venus and Mars.
Them people in the World Trade Center got killed. He was a broker, a banker, a lawyer, an American infidel on her way to Sbarro's to pick up a roll and coffee before her 12-hour shift at Century 21. Well, you know what they say, live like an American, die like a capitalist pig. Well, you know what they say, live in America, die in Kabul. And no more food stamps for benefit cards are fashionable because they look like credit cards. I mean, benefit cards are fashionable because they look like credit cards. And I still can't afford church now, but God lets me hear his music for free. And he whispered, child, open your ears and you can see. Child, open your ears and you can see. Child, open your ears and you can see. Last night, a homeless alcoholic stood outside of a rundown church rocking to the Lord's music, and I stood next to him, and we held hands, and we cried together like we struggled together forever, and we heard the same voice, and curtains of tears fell from my psyche like rain, and we knew Christ could feel our pain, and I felt his spirit flying through me when I hesitantly, softly sang, oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hail at the twilight's last gleaming through thy shores and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watch were so gallant streaming and the rockets rattling, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof
Hope you enjoyed the show.
So now you wanna talk about hope? So now you wanna talk about dreams?
Hip hop.
So now you wanna hear what I wrote? So now you wanna know what it means?
Hip hop.
So now you wanna talk about